Let's start off with an incredible good morning to warm up the blood. Good morning.
Good morning.
Ah, you guys are a beautiful body of humanity. Thank you. I really appreciate that because you know what? I travel all over the country and I get up and I don't even know where I get up. That's how much I travel through the whole country and I get to go among the most inspiring people, farmers and ranchers all over the country. I'm going to talk to you about the soil health movement, ladies and gentlemen, that started with our farmers and ranchers. And how did this thing start? It started out of desperation, ladies and gentlemen. Desperation. Our farmers and ranchers were going broke. The climate, the drought, dealing with the flooding, dealing with the high cost of chemical inputs, petroleum-based products, all those things are putting pressure on our farmers. I had one farmer, a very good friend of mine, Ray McCormick, one day, shared with me, and he says, you know what, Ray? We're both Rays. And he says, you know, I grew up wanting to be a farmer all my whole life. And the day, and then he was telling me this, and you could tell he had a really rough day because part of his fields were flooded that day. And he says, I came in the house and told my wife, you know, I don't know if I want to farm anymore. Those are the kind of pressures that I'm seeing that our farmers are having through the whole country. But there's hope, ladies and gentlemen. I have never seen so much hope, and that we're going to share with you today that hope. We're going to share how we can heal our soils. And when we heal our soils, not only can we bring healing to the land, to our people, to the animals, to everything. Name me a resource issue we do not address, ladies and gentlemen, if we don't fix the soil. We fix water quality. We increase nutrient density in our food, which helps heal our bodies. We heal the climate. We fix a majority of our issues if we make our soils healthy. And I'm going to show you how we're going to do that. That's why I'm so excited. Oh, by the way, our farmers make a healthy income too. Because if we keep them on the land and bring it the next generation on, that's what this is about. This is why I'm so passionate about this, ladies and gentlemen. Because I had producers under my watch were not able to bring their sons and daughters into the operation. No more Band-Aids. I am a captain of putting conservation Band-Aids on the land. No more. I'll just make this one more point. Recently in Omaha, they talked about we want to have 20 million acres of cover crops. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wonderful indicator. I want to change 20 million minds and souls about soil health. I want soil health to be taught at our grade schools, our high schools. I want commercials of soil health on our TV. I want people to connect back to the land. Because if you give people understanding, ladies and gentlemen, they will teach their kids and it will happen perpetually. That's my goal. Bring healing, and you can only bring healing if we give people understanding. It's about the understanding, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to show you the most powerful tool that we use as an indicator of soil health. This is visual. This is a very, very simple test to do. The science for this has been around for many, many years. That's the disturbing part. It's been around for a long time. Okay. What Chris is holding on his right hand is a 40-year no-till from Ray Stiers. Ray Stiers is from North Carolina. His organic matter, we just measured a couple of months ago, is 4.6%. The typical soils in the Piedmont region of North Carolina is typically 3%, even before Europeans entered. The forests are 3%. How did he exceed the forests? He does zero till, one of the principles, zero tillage, multi-species cover crops. He has been doing multi-species cover crops for 30 years. He also uses manure, but he only has enough manure for half the farm. He does not have enough manure. He used to be a dairy man. Now he feeds stockers. Ladies and gentlemen, he is 82 years old. I said, Ray, you're almost organic. Because he doesn't use any more inorganic nitrogen. He does not use any more inorganic phosphorus. He has gone down from 5 herbicides down to 1 herbicide, ladies and gentlemen. I said, you could sell your corn for $17 a bushel. He said, no, Ray, look, I'm 82. I don't even buy green bananas. I might not enjoy them. I said, okay, Ray, that's fine. On the left-hand side, Chris has the same soil, Piedmont clay soil, Cecil sandy clay. They are both the same soil. They are a mile apart. That is a vegetable farm with lots of disturbance, tillage. Okay, look at the color difference. That is 0.5%, left side 0.5%, and then Robert's got our beloved Texas, heavily conventional till soil, okay? Now, we're going to drop these soil clods into the water. This is the way the test works. You drop the clods in, the water is going to rush in to fill the pore spaces. Each clod has millions of pore spaces. If the pore spaces do not fall apart, called slaking, then you're going to have porosity. If you have porosity, you have infiltration. When we have a flood, we want the water to filtrate. When we have a drought, we want the water to filtrate and we want to hold it. For every 1% of organic matter we build, we'll hold 17 to 25,000 gallons per acre, ladies and gentlemen. Big bucket. Okay, so we're going to drop them in. We're going to see which one can withstand the forces. The pressures build up. If it starts falling apart, that is an indicator the soil is not healthy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when you go home, I want you to air dry. Go put the clods in the microwave. They're still wet. The wife might get upset. You might hear screaming actinobacteria in there, but it's okay. So what you're going to do is you're going to put these in, and you're going to test it on your own place. Okay, now remember, this only works on 95 to 98% of the soils. Not all soils will slake. I've done this in Alaska, Puerto Rico, everywhere. But some soils will not slake because of the mineralogy. You ready? Go ahead and drop them into the cylinders. We'll see old Ray Steyer soil holding together. Look at our conventional till soils. Heavily tilled, heavy disturbance. What do we take away this, ladies and gentlemen? Nature does not invert herself. She does not till. She uses earthworms, dung beetles, ants, termites. She uses roots, living roots. Why do I love zero till? Because it emulates the natural ecosystem. One of the principles, limit physical disturbance. They're going to say, you put Elmer's glue in there, Ray. No, I didn't. This is the Creator's glue. Glues that these organisms, the bacteria, the fungus, the earthworms, all these beautiful systems, these biological systems, the biota doing this, the root exudates, all this are created and make organic matter and the glues that hold our pores open. What happened to the glues here, ladies and gentlemen? And I'm telling you, I tried to get my dad to stop with that rototiller. I said, Dad, stop using the rototiller. You're going to burn the house down. Because I had an old rancher tell me, he said, Ray, I'm going to steel disc because I get a release of nutrients. I said, yes, you do. You burn the house down to warm up a hot dog. It would have been better to turn the grill on. Here's what I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen. What happens when you run that disc, that rototiller, you disturb that soil ecosystem, you send a flush of oxygen into the system. Then you wake up these bacteria called R. strategists. They're a type of bacteria that are in all soils, and they're opportunists. They love rich substrates. Those glues are carbon substrates. They're food. So when you break up the aggregate, expose it to oxygen, you wake them up. It's like waking up a bunch of teenagers to eat pizza. And they'll eat and eat and eat and consume and give off a plume of CO2. It happens in hours. They die. They release nitrate. And then guess what else you do when you run the tillage machine? You bring weed seeds to the top of the surface. What we did is stimulate secondary succession. Weeds are nature's healers and scabs. They're the healers and the scabs. We did that in one event. And I wish I would have known. Ready for the next one? Okay. Now here's what we're going to do. We're going to take it to the next level. We're going to create our own little rain simulator. You pour those two. Not yet. We're going to do it together because we got to be fair here. Okay, Chris. Okay, go ahead and hold on a second. Get the camera up. Okay, we're gonna pour it and you're going to get out of the way. Okay, so this is food coloring. That's food coloring. And that's Willie Durham's beer drinking last night. So don't spill it on yourself. No, I'm just kidding. It's food coloring. Okay, now, Chris is right here, is the no-till, Ray Stiers. These both are the same soils. This is the conventional, and this is our beloved Texas conventional. Okay? Let's pour it, because we got holes here. Let's make it rain. Let's create our miniature rain simulator. Because when we have a drought, I want to capture every inch of water. Oh, the no-till. How could the no-till beat the conventional? See, I thought when I went to school, if I stir up the soil, create it more fluffy, and put more, I'll get more pore space. How many thought that? Raise your hand, you did too. It's the opposite. The glue makers keep the pore spaces. Look at the distance here, ladies and gentlemen. That short distance of 12 inches. That kinetic energy of just the raindrop coming causes the pores to plug up, because what happens, the glues are not there, it fills the particles, then you get this crusting effect. You've seen that crust? We created that crust. And then the water runs off, and then you didn't get the water in there. You know what's so critical also too, ladies and gentlemen? Our soils are aquatic ecosystems. Sub-aquatic ecosystem. That means microbes swim in water. The nematodes swim in water. The bacteria swim in water. No water in the soil, no nutrient cycling. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm wrapping it up. I want to thank every one of you for what you do. Thank you for having to deal with the heavy stress that you do every day and deal with the economic stress. And the ecological stress, the rain, and all the things you do because you deal with a very, very complex ecosystem. Thank you for what you do. Thank you.